Let's set the stage. You found two keywords you could target with your next video. For example, how to rank higher in search and how to rank higher on YouTube. You can clearly see that the competition is low enough that your video will be able to rank for either one. But which keyword do you choose? Well, it comes down to which one has the higher search volume. Quick hint, pay attention to the gray cross and the green check. Hey YouTubers, Nico here. Let's talk about search volume on YouTube. This may surprise you. There are only two sources to help estimate the search volume. I mean real sources. Of course, there are countless tools out there that give you the search volume, but they need to get their information from somewhere, right? And only YouTube knows the actual search volume. So the real sources must come from them. The first source that comes to mind is Google's Keyword Planner. Unfortunately, it's aimed towards Google and not specifically towards YouTube. Therefore, it's not a source for search volume on YouTube. Only if you assume that people search the same terms on Google and YouTube, then you may use the Keyword Planner. But I doubt that people on Google are interested in the same things as people on YouTube. So let's move on to the first real source you can actually use. It's Google Trends. Let's type YouTube SEO. And here we go. By the way, it's very important to switch to YouTube search here. Alright. As you can see, we don't get actual search volume numbers, but luckily we don't need them, because we can compare that with a second search term. Let's type in YouTube ranking, and here we go. We can now clearly see that YouTube SEO, shown with a blue line here, has a higher search volume. So of course I would pick YouTube SEO as my target keyword. It can bring me more views. But wait a minute. YouTube SEO is a super competitive search term. In particular, this bad grade tells me that the search results are dominated by big channels. With a small channel like mine, I have no chance to rank here. However, how to rank higher in search and how to rank higher on YouTube are two keywords that are much less competitive, and my small channel has the chance to rank for them. Let's type these into Google Trends. Well, that's a bummer. Google Trends doesn't have enough data. Unfortunately, less competitive keywords also have a lower search volume oftentimes. And Google Trends only has data for keywords that have a considerable search volume. That means, I'm afraid, that Google Trends is not really useful for small YouTubers. But don't fret, my friends. This brings me to the second source for search volume on YouTube that actually works well even for small YouTubers. And that are the search bar suggestions. Here I typed in how to rank higher, and the suggestions already showed how to rank higher on YouTube. This is a very good sign, but you're probably wondering what this has to do with search volume. More than it seems, actually. Let's take a step back and think about how the search bar suggestions work. When the user starts typing, YouTube tries to predict what the user wants to type. But how can YouTube predict what the user wants to type? Well, it's quite easy. YouTube listens to which search terms people enter all the time. This way, it knows which search terms are commonly used. And those commonly used search terms are the ones that YouTube is suggesting. Bingo! This is why the search bar suggestions have something to do with the search volume. Only those terms are listed that have a considerable search volume. If your target keyword shows up in the search bar suggestions, then it is likely that it has good search volume. Unfortunately, however, we still have no exact number. But we have to work with what YouTube is offering us, and especially for small YouTubers, this is really helpful. Let's have a look at how to rank higher in search, for example. When I start typing, I don't see this term. Instead, I only see how to rank higher in the search. You can imagine that this term has a much higher search volume than how to rank higher in search without the. This is actually a really interesting case. The search suggestions are reinforcing themselves. Think of all the people who wanted to type how to rank higher in search without the. I bet most of them type how to rank higher and see how to rank higher in the search and just click it because it's close enough to how to rank higher in search without the. Who would not click the suggestion and rather type out the full term without the? Barely anyone. This effect that people just go with the suggestion is super relevant. That is why it is really important that you target a keyword that shows up in the search bar suggestions. If it doesn't show up, chances are that you won't get the views you expected, even if your video ranks high for that keyword. Please don't make the mistake to try to rank for a search term that people are not commonly using. To help you with that, I baked that into Morningfame's keyword research tool. When you do a search, you can easily see if the keyword appears in the search bar suggestions. How to rank higher in search doesn't. See the gray cross? How to rank higher on YouTube does. See the green check? Now it's pretty clear which keyword I should target. The search bar suggestions are really powerful when we look at it from the search volume perspective, right? It's not giving us exact numbers, but who are we to complain? This information comes directly from the source, YouTube. Thus, the suggestions are very dependable. Cheers, my friends!